Hi everybody, today is February 4th, 2013. South Korea-U.S. military drills kick off amid North Korea nuclear threat. Seoul, South Korea. South Korea and U.S. troops began naval drills Monday in a show of force partly directed at North Korea amid signs that Pyongyang will soon follow through with a threat to conduct its third atomic test. The region has also seen a boost in diplomatic activity since last month, when North Korea announced it would conduct a nuclear test to protest UN Security Council sanctions tightened after a satellite launch in December that the U.S. and others say was a disguised test of banned missile technology. Pyongyang's two previous nuclear tests in 2006 and 2009 both occurred after it was slapped with increased sanctions for similar rocket launches. It also issued its most recent punishment. The Security Council ordered North Korea to refrain from a nuclear test or face significant action. North Korea's state media said Sunday that a high-level Workers' Party meeting leader Kim Jong-un issued important guidelines meant to bolster the army and protect national sovereignty. North Korea didn't elaborate, but Kim's guidelines likely referred to a nuclear test and suggest that Pyongyang appears to have a complete formula, procedural steps, and is preparing to conduct a nuclear test soon. According to South Korean analysis, Hongheim Ik, we assess that North Korea has almost finished preparations for conducting a nuclear test anytime, and all that is left is North Korea's making a political decision to do so. South Korea's Defense Ministry spokesman Kim Min-seok told reporters Monday. The spokesman said he couldn't disclose further details because that would involve confidential intelligence affairs. Recent satellite photos showed North Korea may have been sealing the tunnel into a mountainside where a nuclear device could be exploded. They evidently have the tunnel sealed off and it's all camouflaged now. A North Korean nuclear test seems to be imminent. South Korea's UN ambassador Kim Suk said on Monday at a news conference at a UN headquarters in New York. He said there are very busy activities taking place at the North Korea's nuclear test site and everybody's watching. The ambassador said he expects the Security Council to respond with firm and strong measures in the event of a nuclear test. On Monday, the South Korean and U.S. militaries kicked off a 3 days of exercises off the Korean Peninsula East Coast that involved live fire exercises, naval maneuvers, and submarine detection drills. And I reported on that with that paper from North Korea. South Korea's Joint Chief of Staff said the maneuvers are part of a regular joint military training that the Allies had scheduled before the last nuclear tensions began, but the training, which involves a nuclear-powered American submarine, could still send a warning against possible North Korean provocation. A South Korean military official said, requesting anonymity because of department rules. Late Monday, Pyongyang state media said the drill showed that the U.S. and South Korea had been plotting to attack North Korea and increase the danger of a war on the divided peninsula. See, and this is what I put the link to yesterday, too. The dark cloud of war is approaching to the Korean Peninsula, North Korea official website said in a commentary. Our patience has the limit. They also said that they're not going to let an opportunity to strike the U.S. and the puppet government, which would be South Korea, slip by again. I knew I had stumbled onto something when I posted this last night. Constantly rushing to war, fire clouds. Fire clouds of war on the Korean Peninsula now constantly coming. Now this is the North Korean government propaganda that they're posting. Maritime training and that wish to the U.S. and South Korean optical. And there's some words that have been translated wrong. Kim Jong-un posted this himself. That's why it's got so many misspelled words. And the acute situation in perilous military movements around him. So, Pohang, 4 to 6 days, including anti-submarine training and anti-ship and anti-aircraft training, maritime tactical maneuvers. On the Sea of Japan, maritime training would proceed to the U.S. and the South Korean puppet horror. So the submarine USS San Francisco is there, and that they got that spelled wrong. And the Aegis cruiser, the Shiloh, contributes to South Korea's head. Puppet Navy Aegis King Sejong force is a huge number and destroyers. Submarines, more than 10 ships, it says. Ship and anti-submarine patrol, aircraft, anti-submarine, something else that's spelled wrong, to participate in maritime training. Lovely start to a busy something. I guess what it's saying is these drills are provoking a new war in the Korean Peninsula. Default realization. goes on to say is what you cannot get away with is the bad behavior, for your bad behavior will not be tolerated. And they seem to think that the United States is going to do a preemptive attack, and that the South Korean puppet player radiologically opened. Maybe they figure they'll get the fallout. It says the San Francisco is docked, a mere fact that the big message in the book to pass, and nuclear submarines in the media, did not reveal an interior view of the public. While the purpose of this training, I think is what it means, is for blackmail, a war of aggression and provocation that does not hide. I mean, they're doing these war games, but actually they think the United States is going to push them to war, blackmail for their nuclear tests and for their rocket launch. Evidently, there's a B-2 stealth bomber that flew over from the mainland, too forward deployed in the U.S. The 7th Fleet with South Korea, a tract are going. There's so much misspelling in this, and it's been translated from, you know, Korean. There you can see the original text. I really think that Kim Jong-un himself wrote this. So it goes on and says, there's limits to our patience. We have not sat down loading the United States and the nation's disaster. I like how they put in here the Godzilla War, kind of referring to the old Godzilla movie, so we know what he likes to watch. Those old black and white films from the 50s of Godzilla, who was created out of radiation, fallout, contamination. So if he's watching this video, I'm going to add this for him.
Godzilla, King of the Monsters, alive, surging up from the depths of the sea on a tidal wave of terror to wreak vengeance on mankind.
Godzilla, King of the Monsters, it's alive!
A gigantic beast,
stalking the earth, crushing all before it.
In a cyclonic cavalcade of electrifying horror,
raging through the streets on a rampage.
My sense of humor there for you guys. But this is the part I was talking about that was important. The United States and South Korea puppet dared to misjudge the situation. And if you select a real war, our army and people will not miss again the opportunity. In this priceless remark, fulfilled a long-cherished establishing the nation's top horse. And the other one that I posted yesterday, they were talking about unifying North and South Korea together as one country. They fear they're only going to be able to do this by another war. So I'll give you a link to this article here. You can finish reading it. And a link to his threatening letter. And you can read that yourself and try and make out what you can from it. All right, bookmark my site. I'll keep everyone up to date. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.